A friend asked, "What is the best espresso machine for a beginner?" And I'm like, that is a difficult question. But I can't just say it's this Breville infuser and be done with it. I also understand where you're coming from. You could be used to a pour over right now, or you might be using an espresso or a port machine, or you don't have any coffee machine at home and you just missed the Starbucks on your way to work. I get it. You want to replace this with something that's a good espresso machine. You might think spending more money gets you a better machine. That's also not true. So today, I'll talk about three things that I'll say should factor into this, and we'll talk about a recommendation at the end. The first, training wheels. I'm not kidding. But really, it's always nice to have training wheels. There's just so much to learn. From grinding, to dosing, to tamping, to even frothing your milk. Any help goes a long way. So things like a pressurized basket in a portafilter, or any of these auto-frothing wands, or things that can help wherever it goes. All of this is fun. In this price, of course. How much you spend on your espresso machine is gonna be a big factor into your decision. But think of this like any other hobby. Let's say tennis, and you're just learning tennis. How much should you spend on your tennis racket? You have two options. You can go cheap, and if you're still playing tennis 6 months later, you can probably buy yourself a better racket. Or you could buy an extremely expensive racket and then realize 6 weeks later that you stopped playing tennis. It's probably a waste of your money. So the same thing goes here. Invest proportional to interest in your hobby. And yes, that means all the online forums out there and Redditors who talk about, oh, I wish I'd spent more on my first machine. Yeah, because there's a survivor bias. These are all the people who stuck around and wish they'd spent more. So don't go for the biggest and meanest machine. Go cheap. A sub-segment on price. Just make sure you're buying a grinder along with your espresso machine. I made this mistake. I spent all my money on my first machine and I had a blade grinder for coffee. Bad decision. There are options out there like these combo machines, let's say a Breville Barista Express, which have a grinder and an espresso machine in one. Great for beginners, bad for upgrading later. It is what it is. The last is personality. I'm not kidding, really. These machines have a lot of personality in them and it should match you. Think of it like a car. So a Breville is, and let's say a Breville Barista Express, it's like the top selling car in your country. Out here, it's a Toyota Camry. Reliable, but kind of boring. On the other hand, something like a Gaggia Classic Pro. Ooh, that's like a Subaru. Endlessly modifiable. And it's clearly for some kind of tinkerer, some kind of gearhead who can, you know what, keep on upgrading that machine. Or take a decent. That's something like a Tesla. It's again for a tinkerer, but for a different type of gearhead. Probably a techie. So these machines are a lot about you. I have a Breville infuser. What does that say about me? Oh. That leaves us with a recommendation. My recommendation is that I don't have one. Unlike every other article out there talking about the best espresso machine. Hey, you know what? I just want you to take these factors into mind. Training wheels, price, go cheap. And personality, right? No matter what, it's a tool. And you'll keep on learning in this whole process and you can make great espresso and great lattes in frankly any machine you pick. For those who've just bought a machine, welcome. Welcome to the club. Your wallet will hate you. All right, that's all for today. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.